In the picturesque city of Sydney, nestled on the eastern coast of Australia, lived a young woman named Inaya. She was a finance director at a renowned Australian company, a position she had achieved through hard work, determination, and relentless dedication. Inaya's life revolved around numbers, balance sheets, and financial reports. She was known for working day and night, her unwavering commitment to her career leaving little room for personal time or leisure. Inaya was passionate about her career, but her demanding schedule affected her physical and mental health. Although she was used to the financial department's fast-paced, high-pressure workplace, the ongoing demands were beginning to wear her down. She never stopped pushing herself because she thought her commitment was crucial to her success. Ava, a close friend of Inaya, nevertheless decided to pay her an unannounced visit at her workplace one day. Ava had observed Inaya's altered demeanor and the toll her rigorous work schedule had on her. Inaya looks exhausted, her once vibrant vitality replaced with a feeling of weariness. Ava cared about her friend's health and happiness, so she chose to deal with the problem. Sitting in Inaya's messy office, she couldn't help but talk about how worried she was. Ava proposed that Inaya take a break from her demanding work schedule by traveling to the stunning Australian coastline once a week. Being the caring and organized friend that she was, Ava was in charge of organizing every detail of their beach vacation. She made delectable cuisine for their excursion while meticulously gathering their modest suitcases. She arrived at Inaya's door at 11 a.m. on a bright and sunny Saturday, prepared to start their eagerly awaited excursion. As they traveled towards the picturesque Australian coastline, there was a palpable excitement about the impending retreat. The fantastic sight of the endlessly blue water and the immaculate beaches met their eyes as they approached the coastline. People from all walks of life were swarming the beach for relaxation and peace by the water. Inaya wasted no time leaving the restrictions of her office and embracing the freedom of the open sea. She was eager to plunge into the chilly, alluring waters. Inaya eagerly waded into the water, while Ava and their companions decided to stroll down the shore. Inaya was taking in the healing embrace of the ocean when she noticed some surfers surfing the waves. Their graceful ease and mastery of the water mesmerized her and brought back memories of her love of surfing. She decided to go with them because she wanted to enjoy once again the rush of riding the waves. Inaya climbed onto a surfboard and paddled into the water as Ava and their friends watched from the shore. She was overcome with joy as she caught her first wave and felt incredibly liberated. She was totally at one with the ocean in those priceless moments. Unbeknownst to Inaya, a mysterious creature lurked beneath the water's surface. A powerful predator of the deep, an 11-foot bull shark, had been attracted to the disturbance and movement in the water. A similarly hazardous bull shark also patrolled the area close by. The enormous bull shark suddenly and terrifyingly changed course, leaping upward with incredible speed and crushing Inaya's legs with its formidable jaws. Her life abruptly transformed into a nightmare as excruciating pain radiated throughout her body. She was overcome with fear and panic, but struggled to remain upright. As Inaya's blood mixed with the waves, the water surrounding her turned a horrifying hue of red. She realized she needed to ask for help, even though she was in excruciating pain and on the verge of losing control of her fear. With all the power she could muster, Inaya was able to scream out for assistance. Her voice, weak but persistent, cut through the noise of the breaking waves. Ava noticed the upsetting situation thanks to her keen instincts, and her heart sank as she saw the telltale trace of blood in the water. Ava and the other beachgoers jumped into action without any hesitation. To return Inaya to the safety of the shore, they quickly converged on her and formed a human chain. They fought the unrelenting waves as adrenaline surged through their veins to save their injured companion. Inaya's condition was grave as they arrived at the shore. She was in agonizing pain. Her legs were crushed and dripping with blood. They had to act quickly if they wanted to preserve her life. Ava dispatched an ambulance right away, taking Inaya to the closest hospital. After being informed of her impending arrival, the medical staff worked quickly and precisely to stabilize her condition and get ready for a life-saving surgery on her severely wounded legs. In the operating room, skilled surgeons toiled assiduously to heal the severe harm the shark attack had brought about. It was a tedious and delicate process that called for skilled accuracy. Inaya's survival was in jeopardy, and the medical staff battled valiantly to secure it. Following the terrifying incident, Inaya had a protracted and challenging road to recovery. She was confined to a hospital bed for 3 arduous months, her body weakening and her legs immobile. The tragic event left physical and mental wounds that had taken a long time to heal. Inaya had plenty of time during her protracted rehabilitation to reflect on her life and decisions. Her life had been on the verge of being lost due to her persistent pursuit of her work. The once relaxing and joyful Australian coastline has become the setting for a terrible ordeal. Once upon a time in Canada, there lived a young girl named Jane. She was a 24-year-old university student passionate about creating fresh and engaging content for her YouTube channel. Jane and her dedicated team worked tirelessly to produce videos for their channel every week and on special occasions, like holidays when they had some free time. While browsing YouTube for inspiration one fateful day, Jane stumbled upon a mesmerizing video featuring the vast and enchanting ocean. The sight of the ocean stirred her creativity, and an idea began to take shape in her mind. Jane wasted no time discussing her newfound idea with her fellow YouTube team members. Excitement filled the air as they decided to embark on an adventure to Australia. The idea was to shoot fresh and captivating content in this new and exotic location, far removed from their familiar Canadian surroundings. Booking their tickets on a scorching summer day, July 23rd, they eagerly awaited their departure date. Finally, the departure day came, and they arrived on Australian soil in awe of the country's beauty and magnificence. The architecture, landscapes, and culture all left them in awe. After a long flight, they checked into a comfortable hotel room to rest before their big day of shooting. As they arrived at their chosen destination, Jane's eyes met the sparkling sea, and she felt an irresistible pull towards it. The allure of taking a photo related to swimming in such pristine waters was too enticing to resist. However, a sudden and terrifying realization washed over her as she entered the sea. The water, once inviting, had taken on a foreboding tone. Panic set in as an enormous 11-foot-long bull shark entered the water, lurking dangerously close to her. Desperation fueled her efforts to swim back to safety, but it was too late. The bull shark had already latched onto her arm, and pain seared through her body. The member of her team who was recording everything stood frozen in shock as they witnessed the harrowing scene unfold before their eyes. Jane's arm was filled with waste blood, and she knew she needed help urgently. In a blur of adrenaline and fear, Jane managed to struggle her way back to the safety of the shore, but the damage was done. Her arm was severely injured, and she was bleeding profusely. It was a scene of sheer horror. Jane was rushed to the hospital, where skilled doctors worked tirelessly to save her arm. After a week of intense medical care and surgery, she began the long road to recovery. The incident had left a lasting impact on her physically and emotionally. News of the shocking shark attack spread like wildfire among the students and teachers at Jane's University. It was an incident that nobody could have anticipated, and many found it difficult to believe that such a terrifying ordeal had befallen their beloved YouTube content creator. Over the next month, Jane slowly but steadily recovered from her injuries. Her resilience and determination were an inspiration to her team and her audience alike. Although the incident had shaken her to the core, it strengthened her resolve to continue creating content that inspired and entertained her. In the end, Jane's journey to Australia took an unexpected and traumatic turn, but her passion for storytelling and her commitment to her YouTube channel remained unshaken. She returned home with a permanent scar from her encounter with the bull shark, but was more determined than ever to teach her devoted followers about the wonders and beauty of the world. In 1992, a young woman named Lily lived in a peaceful Canadian village. Living in a small dorm in the heart of Canada, she attended the esteemed University of Toronto to further her education. Rather than becoming a popular student, Lily set herself apart through her persistent commitment to her studies. Her extraordinary accomplishments had secured her a research scholarship at a Canadian institution, demonstrating her unwavering quest for knowledge. For Lily, her life had been a succession of ups and downs, influenced by her family's tiny size and limited means. Nevertheless, her spirit remained unfazed. She constantly desired more from life than what it had dealt her because she had a resilience about her that drove her ambitions. Within the walls of her hostel, an exciting offer surfaced one day. The females in her hostel came up with the idea to travel to Africa to explore the beauty of the continent's seas. The drawback was that they had to combine their efforts to raise the necessary funds for the expedition. Lily eagerly jumped in, never returning from a new experience. But before long, they needed more resources to realize their ambition. In the gloom of their unfulfilled dreams, a ray of kindness appeared. Knowing Lily was having financial difficulties, one of her friends volunteered to help her. Appreciative of this kind deed, Lily and her pals began carefully organizing their journey. When the big day of departure finally came, Lily eagerly checked into the airport with her friends. Lily was filled with a different type of happiness than the other girls, who came from wealthier families and were excited to travel to a new nation. Promptly at 3 p.m., their flight departed, bringing these young women's hopes and goals. Lily couldn't suppress her excitement as the plane took off for their destination, the possibility of seeing the water for the first time. The girls were met with a magnificent view of the vast, shimmering African water as soon as they arrived. They strolled hand in hand along the water's edge, their excitement and laughter filling the air as they were astounded by how distinctive and lovely the coastline was. Lily leaned over and dipped her hand into the glistening waves as she and her friend eventually made their way out to sea in a boat. The feel of the salty, refreshing water across her skin made her happy beyond measure. But sorrow lurked just beyond the surface of this picture-perfect landscape. The boat took an abrupt lurch that knocked Lily off balance. She clutched to the vessel's side, her heart thumping in her chest as panic overtook her. She was horrified to see a massive bull shark hiding just below the surface. At an impressive 11 feet in length, it was an impressive creature that was a fierce hunter of the deep. As a sharp reminder of the danger she now faced, Lily saw her reflection in the water around the boat, and tears welled up in her eyes. Her call for assistance sounded across the air, warning her friends of the impending danger. Desperate to keep their buddy alive, the girls ran to Lily's aid. They witnessed the enormous 6-foot bull shark hovering dangerously near their suffering comrade. Despite their obvious bravery, they were reluctant to put their lives in danger against such a frightening foe. In a fit of despair, Lily thought of a bold scheme. As the bull shark continued to loom menacingly near, she deftly stepped off the boat's side and discreetly dove into the sea. She planned to swim away from the frightening beast and to the safety of the coast. The bull shark's focus changed as she moved, and it noticed her frail body. It closed in with lightning speed, a powerful force of nature refined over millions of years of evolution. During the ensuing confusion, the predator managed to entangle Lily's body. Lily's blood covered the water surrounding the boat, turning it a horrible hue of crimson and leaving her friends stunned and devastated. Their frantic cries for assistance filled the air when they realized how much they had lost. They could not stop it, so they stared helplessly for hours. After capturing its victim, the bull shark withdrew back into the ocean, leaving a horrifically tragic aftermath. After hearing their distress cries, local community members arrived with emergency services shortly after. Pulling Lily's corpse out of the sea was terrifying. The permanent scars from her encounter with the bull shark now scar her once vibrant visage. Word of Lily's untimely death made its way across the little Canadian community, bringing her family immense sorrow. Their hearts were broken, and they would always be in mourning for their cherished daughter, who had gone out into the world with aspirations and ambitions that would never materialize. Ultimately, Lily's tale offers a moving reminder of both life's erratic character and people's relentless strength. Even though her voyage was cruelly cut short, it will always be remembered as evidence of her indomitable drive to overcome great adversity, to discover the world beyond her modest beginnings. Susan, a vibrant young woman, and her family, consisting of her spouse and 2 children, lived in the heart of Africa and actively engaged in their daily work routines. Susan had a demanding job, and her husband and children also held office positions. Amid their busy lives, finding time for leisure and relaxation was a luxury, but an exciting opportunity was about to change that. Susan's business had invited her and her family to view their exquisite artwork and embark on a family tour along the African Sea for a few days. The mere thought of this upcoming adventure brought joy and anticipation to Susan, who had yearned to sit down as a family and create lasting memories. Susan's deep and abiding love for the ocean made this opportunity even more special. Whenever life made her feel overwhelmed or stressed, she would seek solace in the sea. Something about the rhythmic sound of the waves and the ocean's vastness brought her peace and clarity. But above all, she cherished the moments she spent with her family. And this trip was the perfect opportunity to combine her two greatest loves. As the day of their family adventure approached, the excitement in the household was palpable. Susan's husband and children were looking forward to their days off from work, which was perfectly aligned with the planned tour. The day finally arrived and they set off in their vehicle towards the African Sea. The drive was filled with laughter, songs, and the occasional selfie, as Susan's sons excitedly sat in the back, filming the picturesque African landscape. The sea beckoned to them, its blue expanse stretching out as far as the eye could see. Upon reaching the coast, Susan couldn't contain her excitement. She decided the best way to start their adventure was with a short boat trip. The family boarded a small ship, eagerly anticipating the views and experiences that awaited them. However, a sudden problem arose as the ship ventured into the sea. The engine of the ship sputtered and then stopped altogether. The ship, now adrift in the vast ocean, felt unsteady and vulnerable. Fear rippled through the passengers, but the crew on board swiftly sprang into action, attempting to resolve the issue. Meanwhile, amid this unexpected situation, Susan and her sons continued to capture every moment on their camera, turning their ordeal into an impromptu documentary. They documented the rolling waves, the distant horizon, and even the concerned expressions on their fellow passengers' faces. Then, out of the blue, a thrilling yet terrifying moment unfolded before them. An 11-foot bull shark's powerful body, cutting through the water like a sleek torpedo, breached the surface with a graceful leap. Its sheer size and the spectacle of its jump filled Susan and her sons with awe and trepidation. This was an encounter they would never forget. The shark's majestic leap was perfectly timed, and it seemed as if it was attempting to attract the attention of Susan's sons, who were still filming. The camera captured the creature in all its glory, its image forever etched in their memories. The crew, already on edge due to the malfunctioning ship, watched with fear and fascination. As the minutes ticked by, tension mounted on the ship. The crew's attempts to rectify the engine problem were unsuccessful. The passengers, though anxious, remained relatively calm, trusting in the crew's expertise. Susan, ever the optimist, tried to maintain a sense of composure, knowing that panicking would only make the situation worse. But then, a chilling turn of events unfolded. The bull shark reappeared, this time dangerously close to the ship, possibly attracted by the commotion and the smell of blood in the water. It became clear as it veered towards Susan's side of the vessel. Panic surged through the passengers as they watched in horror. In the blink of an eye, the bull shark lunged out of the water, its massive jaws snapping shut with a bone-chilling force. Susan, caught off guard by the sudden attack, could not react in time. The shark's head-on collision with the ship's side resulted in a gruesome and terrifying spectacle. Blood spattered, and Susan's head bore the brunt of the impact. She was left reeling, unbalanced and injured, with the shock of the encounter sending shivers down her spine. The crew, witnessing this horrifying turn of events, immediately shifted their focus from repairing the ship to ensuring the safety of the passengers. Their fear was palpable as they realized the dangerous nature of the situation. Susan's husband and sons, seated nearby, were now faced with the trauma of witnessing their beloved wife and mother under attack. Despite the chaos and fear, the crew worked tirelessly to initiate the ship's emergency protocols. Their primary objective was to navigate away from the danger zone as quickly as possible. The safety of the passengers was their utmost priority, and they did everything in their power to avert further tragedy. As the ship began to move away from the area where the shark had appeared, the passengers could finally breathe a sigh of relief. Susan, though injured and shaken, was alive. The crew's quick thinking and prompt action saved her life. However, the traumatic event they had just witnessed left her husband and sons extremely shaken. The ship continued its journey back to the shore with the immediate danger behind them. The passengers, now subdued and contemplative, sat in silence, each grappling with the shock and fear that had gripped them just moments earlier. Susan's family huddled together, their concern for her overriding any other emotions. Upon reaching the shore, the family wasted no time getting Susan the needed medical attention. She was rushed to a nearby hospital for a thorough examination and treatment. The doctors worked diligently to assess her injuries and stabilize her condition. It was a tense and anxious period for her family as they awaited news of her condition. The medical team determined that Susan had suffered a severe head injury due to the shark's attack. The impact had caused a significant wound and internal trauma. In the coming days, Susan underwent surgeries and received extensive medical care to ensure her recovery. Her husband and sons, meanwhile, stood by her side, offering unwavering support and love during this challenging time. While concerned about the extent of Susan's injuries, the doctors were cautiously optimistic about her chances of recovery. However, they emphasized that it would be a slow and arduous process, requiring patience and determination. Susan remained in the hospital with her family at her bedside for 3 days. The support of her loved ones, combined with the dedicated care of the medical staff, played a crucial role in her recovery. Each day brought small improvements, and Susan's strength and resilience began to shine through. As Susan gradually regained her health, her family took solace in the fact that she had survived such a harrowing ordeal. Their bond grew stronger, and they cherished every moment they spent together. The experience reminded them of life's fragility and the importance of cherishing each other. In time, Susan could return to her beloved ocean with newfound respect and caution. She no longer took the sea's beauty for granted, but embraced it with humility and awe. On these trips, her family joined her as well, and they treasured every second they had together by the water. As the years passed, Susan and her family continued living to the fullest, savoring every moment and cherishing the memories they created together. They still had a special place in mind for the African Sea, which had once been a place of solace, but was now a representation of triumph over adversity. There they faced their fears and became stronger as a loving, resilient family.